I recently made a spindle lock for my lathe that works by using a 3/8 inch bolt to compress a collar around the spindle. Works very well, but I didn't like having to use a ratchet or wrench anytime I wanted to tighten it. So I threw together a quick and dirty knob to go over the head of the bolt. After using it, I realized that there was a lot of room for improvement. There are many aftermarket plastic knobs available that are designed to have a hex head bolt slide through them, but I didn't really want plastic. My solution was to make a new aluminum knob to finish up this project. Greetings, fellow DIYer, and welcome to my video. I started this project by taking a piece of 3/8 inch thick plate aluminum, cutting it roughly to shape, drilling a hole in the middle, and then fitting it up to an expanding mandrel that I made so that I could put it in the lathe and true it up. Once I had a nice circle, I installed the expanding mandrel into a collet block and took it over to the mill. The nice thing about using the collet block is it allows me to cut the divots in the handle and have them be perfectly spaced. In this particular case, it's a hexagonal collet block that I'm using, so I will end up with 6 divots. Each time I placed the collet block in the vise, I used a straight edge as a guide so I could put it in the exact same position every time. If you're wondering why the cutting fluid is red, it's because it's automatic transmission fluid. I've found that ATF is one of the best cutting fluids when working with aluminum. One thing that I didn't notice when I was doing this project, but I can clearly see now that I've sped the film up, is the collet block was actually moving ever so slightly as I was cutting the notches. If I had it to do all over again, I would have made 2 significant changes to help eliminate this issue. First, I would have used my 4-inch vise instead of my 3-inch vise. That would have given me a little more clamping power. And second, I would have done conventional milling instead of climb milling. I'm actually adding extra pressure by doing the climb milling, and I think things would have gone a little easier had I milled from the other side. Here is my rough cut knob. I need to go in and chamfer all the edges so that they're nice and rounded so they don't end up hurting my hand when I'm using it. And I also need to drill the center hole out to 3/4 inch. But at this point, the body of the knob is pretty much done. So here's where the magic happens. This is a very cheap import style 9/16 socket with a 1/4 inch drive. It came from a kit that I got when I didn't have enough money to afford good tools. And I actually have a whole bin full of various sizes of sockets. This is what I will be using to attach the handle to a bolt head. I started by chucking it up in the lathe and drilling out the center hole to 3/8 inch. This is one situation where going with the 1/4 inch drive rather than a 3/8 drive socket is an advantage because you end up with a perfectly round 3/8 hole as opposed to a 3/8 square hole that a 3/8 drive socket would have. There are several ways to accomplish the next step. I found the easiest way is to take a bolt and put it into the socket in reverse. This allows you to chuck the socket up in the lathe, but also gives you access to the side so that you can turn it down to the correct diameter to be a press fit into the knob. Not only does turning the socket down make it the correct fit into the knob, but it also gives you a nice shoulder so that everything sits square when you assemble the knob and the socket together. Once the turning operation was done, I faced off the end of the socket so that it was just a hair bigger than flush with the end of the bolt I was using. The last step is the final assembly of the knob. The socket is indeed a press fit into the knob, but it's not a super tight press fit. I decided to use some Loctite sleeve retainer, and this will make up for the lack of tightness in the fit. If you're wondering why I put a piece of cardboard underneath the knob, it's simply there to protect the finish of the knob. Once I get the socket seated in the center hole of the knob, I like to do a couple of really small pulls on the press just to make sure everything is sitting nice and tight. I don't want to just reef on it, as that will smash the aluminum, but I do definitely want to make sure everything is snug. I am extremely happy with how that came together. Here it is installed on my spindle lock. Not only does it look a lot better, it functions way better as well.
If you like what you've seen, please click like. If you'd like to see more, please subscribe. Thanks for watching.